Imagine a world in which your medical care is tailored just for you. Using information about your environment, history, and genetics, your doctors could customize your healthcare. For example, if your genetic information showed an increased risk for certain cancers, they could recommend a specific screening plan. If your genetic information showed you wouldn't respond well to a medication, they could prescribe you a different one. Doctors could better use genetic and other information about their patients to give the right people the right treatments at the right time. Every day, we get closer to this goal, but we still have more to learn. Why? For starters, analyzing a person's genetic information is not as simple as you might think. Each person's genetic code, while overall very similar to everyone else's, has thousands of changes from person to person. These are part of what makes us unique. Some genetic changes may have no noticeable effect, or may contribute to minor differences between us, like eye color or blood type. Others may have significant impact on our health or development, such as the changes that cause conditions like cystic fibrosis or sickle cell anemia. Genetic testing laboratories try to categorize each change they find into groups based on what information is available about the change. If the lab finds compelling evidence that the change has no significant effect on health, they categorize it as benign. Likewise, if they are able to find significant evidence that the change causes a particular disease, they categorize it as pathogenic. However, this distinction is not always clear. For many genetic changes, there is simply not enough available information to put it into either category. When this happens, the change is categorized as uncertain. The more information available about genetic changes, the more laboratories can move changes from uncertain into the pathogenic or benign categories, making it easier for doctors to use that information to guide their patients' care. One of the best ways to help classify these changes and to gather more information is for laboratories, patients, and doctors to share their findings. When we pool our information together, we are better able to learn from each other's experiences. Many genetic testing laboratories currently share a summary of the information they have about specific genetic changes with other doctors, laboratories, and researchers. This summary information is very generalized and does not contain any protected health information, such as names, dates of birth, medical record numbers, or doctors' names. This summary is created by merging information from many tests together and typically includes the total number of times the lab has seen a particular genetic change, a group description of the people they have seen it in, and whether or not they think it's related to a specific genetic condition and why. For example, a laboratory has seen a certain genetic change in 5 people they have tested. The change was found in 4 females and 1 male. Of those 5 individuals, 2 were Caucasian, 1 was African American, and the other 2 individuals' race or ethnicity was not specified. 4 of the 5 individuals had breast cancer, 1 had ovarian cancer, and 1 had developmental delay, which is not a typical symptom for people with changes in this gene. As you can see, we cannot tell which of the 5 people had each of these health conditions. This is helpful, but it would be even more helpful if the doctors and researchers knew more about each individual, not just the group as a whole. For example, which people had breast cancer? Which had ovarian cancer? Did anyone have both? Which one had the developmental delay? Does anyone have other unique genetic changes? Could those be causing their reported health issues?